Hi there, and welcome to What Is It Wednesday? Today's question covers 4th edition task list item FK14 or 5th edition task list item B3. And today's question is, what kind of stimuli are paired in respondent conditioning? And the answer is an unconditioned stimulus and a neutral stimulus. The thing about the word conditioning that confuses everybody is that it's sort of always associated with learning, right? When you think about operant conditioning. But in respondent conditioning, the word conditioning is describing the pairing of antecedent stimuli. And those antecedent stimuli are unconditioned stimuli and neutral stimuli. So if you think about Pavlov and his dog, what's being paired is the unconditioned stimulus of food or meat powder and the neutral stimulus of the bell. The bell is neutral because it does not elicit salivation. It's neutral to that behavior. And so when those two things are paired, a unique phenomena occurs, which is that the bell becomes conditioned as a conditioned stimulus or conditioned to be a conditioned stimulus. So yes, conditioning sounds like learning, but it's not behavior that's being learned. It's stimuli that are being paired, and through that pairing, stimuli are becoming conditioned to elicit reflexive respondent behaviors, which of course then are referred to as conditioned responses, even though they are still reflexes. I do hope that helps, and I'll see you next time.